In the United States, we have an obesity epidemic. We have an 80% obesity rate. What's up, Tim and Alter? Today we are talking about a topic that is extremely exciting for me. I know that this is a huge pain point and struggle for a lot of people when it comes to weight loss and sustaining that weight loss. And this has to do with the general topic of nutrition. So in today's video, my goal is to take a very complex subject and hopefully dissect it and simplify it in a way that provides you with some very insightful action steps that you can provide in your lifestyle today to start losing weight and keeping the weight off for good, right? And notice that I said lifestyle, right? This is a lifestyle change. This is not some sort of fad diet, right? Where oftentimes you go on this up and down roller coaster of weight loss and weight gain, right? This should be action tips that you can apply to your life day in and day out so that you can lose weight and keep the weight off for good over a long period of time, right? So the first tip deals with portion control, right? And it sounds simple, but it's a lot more difficult than it is, right? There is a reason why in the United States we have an obesity epidemic, right? You look at any other country, Russia, Turkey, Japan, right? As a matter of fact, Japan has less than a 4%, exactly 3.6% obesity rate versus here in America where we have an 80% obesity rate, right? So there's clearly a problem and it all starts here when it comes to portion control, right? So what does that mean when it comes to real life practice? Well, that means eating until we're full and then knowing when to stop, right? And this is a huge thing, right? There's two problems of why we overeat, right? The first thing is our busy schedules, right? We're running around trying to fit in the next meal as quick as possible so that we can get back to our work. But the problem with that is that we're eating so fast that we're not giving our brains enough time to process the fact that we're even full, right? So we need to slow down when we're eating so that we can have a small to medium-sized meal and be satisfied without overeating a bunch of calories, right? The second culprit is actually the food companies and manufacturers themselves, right? Between advancements in technology and just the overall growth of the industry as a whole, they've been able to cost efficiently produce food at scale, right? And this is not just any kind of food. We're talking about food that is loaded with preservatives, loaded with sugar, right? And as a matter of fact, according to the US Department of Agriculture and Health, sugar is 8 times as addictive as cocaine, right? 8 times as addictive as cocaine, right? So there's no doubt why these companies are loading their foods with sugar, right? It is addicting. They want us to consume these foods and be fat, right? The fatter we are, the more that we consume these foods, the more money that these companies make, right? So the trend is that the higher the obesity rates are, the better business is for these companies, right? So we need to stay away from a lot of these processed foods, foods that are loaded with calories and sugar, right? And worry about portion control, right? Have that small to medium sized meal, right? So that we're full and call it a day. That is it, right? Tip number two, right? Deals with fried foods. We need to eliminate them altogether. I know you're probably saying, but Zach, I love fried foods. Well, I love fried foods too, right? I'm not some weird human being who does not love fried foods. I love it, right? It's full of fat and oil, but the reality is that it is loaded with calories. As a matter of fact, according to the US Department of Agriculture and Health, a 1/2 pound of fried chicken is 570 calories and 29 grams of carbohydrates versus a grilled, right, 1/2 pound of chicken breast, which is 410 calories and 0 carbohydrates, right? So you can see that there is a huge difference in nutrition facts between fried foods and grilled foods, right? You wanna stick with the grilled lean meats, right? So chicken breast, lean turkey and ham, roast beef, right? Stay away from the fried food options and do not be afraid to alter food menu items, right? I do this all the time personally when I go through a drive-thru, for example, and I see a fried chicken sandwich, I will ask them if they can make it a grilled chicken sandwich instead. And if there's a bunch of toppings and sauces, for example, I'll remove the toppings and I'll ask for the sauces on the side so that I can put them on myself at a smaller amount, which perfectly segues into tip number three, which deals with sauces, right? We need to be a lot more mindful and cautious when it comes to sauces, right? We think mentally, psychologically, because it is a liquid substance that it doesn't have calories. That cannot be further from the truth, right? Mayo, for example, has 94 calories per tablespoon, and ranch has 70 calories per tablespoon. So sometimes even when we think that we're going the healthier route by having a salad, once you put on the ranch dressing, you might as well be having a burger from McDonald's because the calorie count is the same, right? On average, Americans have about 2 tablespoons of ranch dressing on their salad, right? That is 140 calories worth of dressing on a salad alone, not even including or factoring in croutons, cheese, onion rings, whatever other toppings that you're putting onto it, right? So we need to be mindful of sauces. Preferably, you eliminate them altogether. But if you do need to have some sauce for flavor, preferably you stick to the lower calorie sauces like ketchup and mustard. Ketchup, for example, has 17 calories per tablespoon. Now, this is not an excuse to just go crazy on the ketchup and the mustard, right? Preferably, again, you just eliminate all sauces. But if you need to put sauce on your food, be very mindful at putting a very small amount, preferably less than a tablespoon. Last, but certainly not least, is dealing with beverages, right? This is huge. A lot of us have a lot of soft drinks, whether we're eating at a fast food restaurant, at a nice restaurant, or even if we're just eating at home, right? We should just be drinking water, right? Sodas have on average about 100 calories per can of soda. Tea, for example, sweet tea has 70 calories per 8 ounce of sweet tea. So we preferably just want to have water, right? Water has 0 calories and it is a great natural appetite suppressant. It helps in huge ways when it comes to weight loss, mental clarity, increasing work productivity. I mean, there's a bunch of studies on water done alone. As a matter of fact, a study done from the National Center for Biotechnology Information took 2 groups of people. One group consumed 17 ounces of water before each meal throughout the day, and the second group consumed no water at all before each meal. And they found that over a 12-week period of time, the group that consumed 17 ounces of water before each meal lost an average of 44% more weight than the group that did not have any water at all. So you can see how powerful water is for overall weight loss and just better results overall when it comes to nutrition, right? So preferably, you're only sticking to water. If you cannot do plain water, there's a lot of options to add flavor, right? They have it in any local food store. You can get the flavor infusers that you just put a few drops in the water of whatever flavor that you like, or you can take a pitcher of water and put it in the refrigerator overnight, marinating in your favorite fruits. I personally like strawberries, so sometimes I'll leave strawberries in a pitcher of water. The longer that the water sits with the fruits, the more intense the flavor is. But preferably, you just stick to water. So these are the 4 action tips that you can implement into your lifestyle today to start seeing immediate results when it comes to weight loss and keeping the weight off for good. So just one last time to recap. Number 1, portion control, right? Having small to medium-sized meals, portion control. Number 2, eliminating fried foods, right? Sticking with grilled and roasted lean meats like chicken, lean ham and turkey, roast beef. Number 3, sauces. Eliminate or reduce sauce intake because they are very calorically dense. You will pack on a bunch of calories with sauces alone. 4th, right, beverages. Only stick to water. Try to eliminate sodas and all soft drinks and only drink water. Huge for weight loss and overall energy and a natural appetite suppressant. So these are the 4 action tips. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. I hope that it was helpful for you. Leave your comments below. Tell me what you thought about the video, and I want to hear from you. What is your biggest struggle when it comes to weight loss? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you again. Until next time.